Hey guys, it's Music Clues here. Welcome to Black Relic's Sea of Thieves gameplay. Laura and I are recording on an individual end, so you'll be able to see from both of our point of views. But today we are going to be showing off Black Relic's, the new update that just dropped for Sea of Thieves. So, Laura was a little bit ahead of me, so she already started recording, but I've already started recording on my end, so yeah, if we're in a loop, that's probably why. Also, we're going to take this advantage to show off the new Hide the Game Attack feature that they added. About time, Lawyer. Yeah. I'm pretty sure it's in options. Got it. All right, here we go. How many of the balloons? I'm not 100% positive. I'll have to look in on that. You loading in? Nice. I should be joining soon. Still loading. Okay, I'm in game. All right, let's talk to Duke here.
Got any exciting tales to share?
All right, so which one do you want to do, Lola? We have the wilds, the Shores of Plenty, or the Ancient Isles? Well, at the moment, we're in a wild storm. Give me a second. Plunder Outpost. So should we do Ancient Isles? Let me just get the scroll then.
Here's to the open sea.
Thankfully I do. I have 15 doubloons.
Alright, good for you.
Don't be careful out there.
You loading in? Whoa! Oh jeez, it's storming out there pretty badly. I think I'll wait out the storm. Ugh. Yeah, they did. Oh, by the way, I don't see a game tag at all. Careful, Laura. They may have changed it so the sloop doesn't get hit, but they didn't change it so you don't get hit. Is the storm clearing up? If you insist. Just a regular cannonball? Oh, come on, man. Banana, coconut, ooh, cursed cannonball. For those who are new, these things are very valuable. Word of advice, don't keep them in barrels, period. Always hold on to them. Yeah.
Yeah, for some reason they were just very, very, they put them away in a barrel.
Yeah, so all word of advice is just hold on to them. You okay over there? Yeah, I do. Here we go. All right. Funda Valley? Yeah. Northwest. Yep. Oh boy. Okay, well you better be careful then. Yeah, just trying to get us out of the storm. Is Plunder Outpost straight ahead? Sai. Up over there. Which one, on the left or the right? The left, okay. Oh shoot. Okay, I'm gonna need to go around. It's clear I nearly lost the control of the ship again. Oh, I know what I'm doing. Now with that lock in the way. Okay, looks like we're gonna be going back directly into the eye of the storm, so. Huh? Hell, what are you doing? Yep, there's Plunder Valley. And we won't be able to get into there without getting lightninged. Hurry and get ready to anchor this thing, I have no control over this. Now would be a good time to hit the anchor. Okay, let's be careful here. Am mine not disappearing on me every 5 seconds? And so far, no gunpowder skeletons. No, I was just saying. Yeah, we haven't run into a single one. Okay, I spoke too soon about the gunpowder skeleton. Got it. Whoa. Nice. Ooh, a bottle. How you doing over there? Coming. Coming. You're in the cave, I assume? Above it? Whoa. Now you tell me. Must be on the opposite side.
You back on the boat? Side down or there?
Hang on, I might have to figure out what side is the side we parked on. Ah, there it is. Okay. Right here.
Up here.
Hang on a second, Em. Em, I can't keep up with you. Where are you? Oh, there you are. Mad Miss Terra. You gotta turn it in? Do you have the skull? Hang on a second. I'll be right back, Em. Alright, I'm back. So how are we gonna get out of here? Oh. Yeah, I can. Let me heal up first. Alright. Never mind. That was quick. The light? There you go. As you can see, guys, teamwork is key when it comes to Sea of Thieves. And I do mean teamwork. Which way do we have to go? Whoa! Okay, maybe not stand right there. Whew. Okay, I'm not gonna lie, that one kinda scared me. There you go. And let's get out of here. Like the storm wants to follow us. Uh-oh. Shifu. Okay, you need to keep going northeast. Oh, don't worry. It's not likely you could run into a megalodon or anything. Sorry, what? Okay. Oh, shoot. Stop the boat. There we go. Patching. Yes, this is Full Saloon. One of us is gonna have to stay aboard the ship to make sure it doesn't sink. Hopefully you guys don't mind me bailing a bit. Like I said, teamwork is key when it comes to this game. Especially when in a stormy situation like this. M? I think I just spotted a beam of light. You know what that means. That means it's one of those Reaper's chests. Fair enough. But just so you go, no, guys, that's the beam of light they were talking about. About earlier. That's what you need to keep an eye out for in the world if you're looking for one of those Reaper's chests. Any luck, Em? Sounds good. Is it one of the new harpoon ones or a regular rowboat? It's a, see. Well, we'll find more rowboats. We'll find more rowboats later. Later. Nice, you found another Dark Relic. Seems like the storm's coming down. We're at chapter 3 now. Oh, I know that. Crook's Hollow, you said? Southeast. So as you can see guys, storms are kind of basically the bind of any Sea of Thieves game. You want to avoid them as much as possible because while you can't necessarily sink from one. Oh, there's the beam of light. Now you guys can see it a little bit more clear now that the storm's gone. That's what you want to look for one of those Leapeth chests. Yeah, and also definitely don't do it during a very important voyage. Like if you saved a gilded voyage, like I have. I actually haven't used it yet. Then I would not do it right now. That's just asking for trouble. Okay, that is southeast from us. You just let's go. So you gotta pass Snake Isle and Stefan's Spoils to reach Crook's Hollow. Just some landmarks to keep in mind. Yeah. I guess while I'm at it, since for possibly any newbies, and I'm pretty sure there are, I guess I could show around the ship. So, this is your armory. This is where you'll be able to change out your weapons and stuff. And right next to it is your ammo chest, where you'll be able to reload your gun. Yep. Yep. This is your clothing chest, where you can change out your clothes. This is your wood barrel. Now, wood is essential to Sea of Thieves. In fact, I would not leave an outpost without gathering as much wood as you can out of those barrels, because... Yeah. Then we have food barrels. Each of your barrels come stocked with bananas at first, but you can get other stuff like coconuts and other food out in the world. They just added that as part of the anniversary update, so...
Yeah, but as the
content, guess what? Bananas are fresh. Yeah, they used to be OP, but not anymore. And then your equipment chest is basically where you can trade out for cool types of, where you can trade out for different styles. Like, you can get different style buckets, fishing rods, drums, shovels, etc., etc. That's where some of the, we haven't had a couple of those in a while, but, hey, I'm not against it. Now this is where you store all your cannonballs. Like I said, do not put any cursed cannonballs in there, or you'll lose them. Trust me on this. Obviously, these are your cannons. Each ship comes loaded with, each sloop comes loaded with two, so you can use two cannons. And each... Uh-oh. Good thing I'm still recording, huh? Uh-oh. You got kicked. Okay, guys, hang on a second. I got a re-invite her. Alright. Let me just find us an island to land on, guys. Guys, so that way we can wait for Laura to load back in. Well, I guess we can introduce at least the front of the ship. So this is where you obviously steer the ship. You can use the left, and to the right, and if you hear this click sound, that means that your ship, well, ship, you are at the middle part. Oh! Ooh, treasure! Focus, focus, MC, focus. Perfect. This island's far enough that I think we can wait. Perfecto. We'll just park here and wait for Laura to jump back in. So anyways, continuing on with my tour of the ship. You have two harpoon guns, and you can use these to harpoon anything, basically anything you want. They also work as great emergency brakes, so yeah, use them as well as you can. These lanterns are also cool too. If you die via a certain way, like if you get poisoned by a snake, or you get killed by a skeleton, you'll notice when you respawn on the ghost ship. That there is a certain color of light. You take the light using your lantern, then, yeah. So, yeah. Now, back here is your treasure map. Is your map of the whole world. So, Sea of Thieves is split up into four different parts. The Wilds. The Ancient Isles. The Shores of Plenty, and over here, just recently added as part of the map, the Devil's Roar. Should warn you that don't call it that for no reason. That place is full of volcanoes, so sail at your own risk. That's all I say. Now, up here, on the mast, this is where you can change your sail and flag. Laura already has a flag ready. And this is where you can put up your alliance flag, so you can offer to be an alliance for somebody. That sounds like him. Good. I parked on a side island to wait for you to get back in game before we jump into the next part of it. Yeah, I am. Weird. Hey, Hey, it's cool. If it makes you feel better, Em, I'll put on your voice inside here so that way people can hear you. Alright guys, so just so you know, in case you didn't hear that, Laura's gonna be joining us. I just sent her an invite. I'm gonna have her voice on so that way you all can hear what she's saying. Obviously I'm recording through my capture card so you can hear what I'm saying, but Laura can't because I'm talking to her via Skype. Oh, one thing you didn't notice though, they did, for those who haven't played Sea of Thieves in quite some time, and I'm pretty sure you haven't noticed, but they added notifications. So if someone's leaving your crew or someone gets disconnected, now they'll send you a notification when someone's joining your crew or leaving, which is a good thing because you never know what could happen. You joining in?
Yeah, I'm playing on Xbox Game Board to load in. Right. It's annoying.
But yeah, that's basically your entire entire ship tour. Guess I should go over what the items you can use inside the game are too. So the top wheel here, that's your food. You can hold up to seven items, I believe. Leave for food, depending.
No, it's five.
Oh, okay, five. Thank you. Items of food at once. So, yeah, make sure that's fully stocked before going on to a very risky challenge, because you never know when you can get killed. Cannonballs, obviously, you can use these to shoot via your cannons on your ship, or basically any cannon that you find on an island. Planks, obviously, is important. Also, you can only hold up to five of these. You can use these to repair holes on your ship. And trust me when I say you're going to really need to make sure you have five planks ready at all times, because you never know when a hole will pop up. Then you have your magnifying glass, which obviously you can use to see things far away. Then you have your shovel. Obviously, this is used for digging. Your lantern.
It might
It's cool. It's okay. But anyways, the lantern you can use to light up your path. It's a very useful item. The bucket, obviously, as you saw me, it's useful, good for your bailing water. Definitely gonna need this at all costs. Compass. Obviously, it's good for the steering in the right direction. Now, your ship's compass will obviously be able to point in the right direction no matter what. But if you're on foot looking for a treasure, it definitely is a very helpful item. Then we have the megaphone. Obviously, I don't have it plugged into my Xbox controller, so you guys literally can't hear it. But I can use this to magnify my voice. Then we have a fishing line, which was added as part of the anniversary update. So basically, you can fish. I'm not going to fish right now, but yeah. Just a little side activity. Yep. Then you have your little beer cup. You can use it. You can use this to do a celebration of sorts. I'm not gonna do it just because I don't want to be drunk at the moment. But yeah. Then you have your. Yeah. So be careful. But also, it's useful. Then you have your instruments. You start off. You have several. You have a drum. The all classic accordion. And finally, this weird thingy. I'm not sure how this thing works, but yeah. And then finally, last but not least, you have your in-game clock timer. This shows what the in-game time currently is. Now note that Sea of Thieves does not do it in real time. It's all in-game, so it's not going to go at the exact same speed. All events that do take place, like time-limited cosmetics, those are all outside game time. But like stuff for merchant and all that, that's all in-game, so you got to be careful. It's cool, and it gives me a chance to show the fans what Sea of Thieves is all about. No kidding. Okay, now we got you got your weapons. At the moment, outside of obviously the stuff on your ship, you got two. You got your trusty sword. Very useful for killing skeletons. And if you press the lunge button, you can lunge at a skeleton. It's very useful, trust me. Little trick that I also learned is that if you jump at the end, you can also use it to launch off your ship. I won't show an example, but oh, Laura's drawing the clue. Just like that. It's cool. But yeah, the other weapon that you have is your trusty gun. You can only shoot 5 bullets at a time, so use them wisely. And you got to be dead center. If you see 4 lines when you're aiming at a target, that means you hit the opponent dead on. So, Lola is a very good shot. True.
Yeah, I think I was an ace on a shotgun and all that. Like, and then, you know, break came along and didn't have to use as much.
Yep. And finally, there's three types of maps inside of Sea of Thieves. There's more, but I wanted to show them off. So the first type is a treasure map. Now these maps show you where there's treasure hidden. You can get these maps from the gold holders. At first they're free, but as you level up, they will cost more gold. So as you can see with this treasure map, it has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 treasure chests. But they're all guarded by skulls, so we're not going to be tackling that one. Then we have a merchant's quest. These are Laura's favorite in game. You basically gotta deliver certain stuff in time. So, for example, you gotta this one says you gotta deliver a fruit of crate. One crate of fruit. Now that isn't easy. Easy, I'll say that much. There's also cloth and glass bottles. But I would be extra careful about those glass bottles because, let's just say they break easy. So, yeah. And then finally, we have Order of Souls, which is what this is kind of like. Order of Souls is basically hunting down skeletons and getting the skulls, just like these. Nice! And just when I finished up my explanation. Alright, let's get going. What? Golden skeletons? Just so you guys know, golden skeletons can be a real pain in the rear if you're not careful. Which way? Oh, that way. I totally knew that. Cut a guy a little slack. Act okay? Sheesh. But yeah, I hope you enjoyed my little Muse Clues guide to how to play Sea of Thieves. Yep. So, yeah, if you guys have any more questions, obviously you can ask me Laura over on Twitter, or you really just chat with us on Discord, but, I'm pretty sure I covered basically everything you need to know about Sea of Thieves, Thieves to Science, and now you're about to get a taste of... Exactly. All right, there's Crook's Hollow. Up top. What do you think? I'm looking. I hear the music. Do you see anything? Guess what I just found?
What?
A castaway, Ashen's castaway chest.
Nice. I haven't seen them. Do you mind?
Sure. Yep. Let me just put this chest. Down here. I'm doing it. Yeah, I did. A little help would be nice. Cave right next to the ship. No.
Aw,
so am I. I found him. Again, in the cave right next to the ship. Yeah.
Okay, great. Finally, thank the Lord.
When you get to this, when you get to the crossway, turn to the right. So that gives me a chance to show all the fans this. So, like I was saying earlier, if you die thanks to a skeleton, you could take that flame. Alright, I'm right here. You behind me, Em? Yeah. Shoot. Okay, something tells me we're gonna need some cannonballs. Yep. Alright. I know. Yeah. Hey, am I moving the ship a little? You think that's the last of them? Got it. What? Final chapter. Oh, you took care of it. You okay? Here, have a banana. You okay now? A fort? Oh. I'm not looking forward to this one. Yeah, I know. What direction? Thank you. So what are we supposed to do here? You just had to say that. You, look what we got spawned on us. Nice. Nice job! We found all three. Nice, we got accommodation, Ancient Darkness. While we're here, we might as well stock up. Interesting. What, the audio glitch? Which one's the closest? Yeah. Well, let's get over the Ancient Spire then, if that's the
Okay, you wanna, what do you want to do, like, for?
Plunder? Sure. Yeah, let's just head to Plunder. South it is. At the moment, moment 10. Yep. Well, let's save that for another recording. I'm nearing 8 gigabytes M on this thing. Fig for the recording. If we take any longer, it's gonna take all night to night to upload. Well, I hope you guys have really enjoyed this Sea of Thieves experience with us, because this was the first time we actually managed to do a full recording without anything happening. Yep. Yeah, as soon as I get this one saved, of course. Yep, we are approaching it. Oh. Doesn't look like it. For all we know, they could be friendly. Rainbow. Okay. How am I supposed to know? Uh-oh, they're trying to harpoon us. Yeah, I am. Coming. If I could ditch the ship. Ha 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 ha! You missed!
Huh?
Uh-oh. Missed again! Try me, suckers! Of course I will! All right, M, go, go, go. Get this stuff off the that's before they decide to change their minds. Not gonna do that. Just gonna anchor. Oops. Hurry up, Em. Okay, well, who do I turn this into? I'm right here. The shell star Ashen's chest.
Shoot, I died too. And that's the type of behavior we were talking about. Looks like those losers got our treasure. Hey, we at least showed us game through the quest, so that's an improvement.
Yeah.
All right, I think we better cut it here. We're about 2 hours on footage, and I'm not sure how much space I'm gonna have on my laptop once this renders. So.
All right.
All right, that's all for now, guys. Thank you for tuning in. Where are you, Lula?
I'm in the tavern right now. Where are you?
Coming back to the tavern. Alright, that's all for now, guys. Thank you once again for tuning into this special episode of Sea of Thieves. We got a lot done. I gotta admit, that's pretty impressive for both of us.
Yeah, for you at least.
Yeah, I guess you got a point. Alright, I guess we better do the wave emoji, so.
Yep. Bye, guys.
Bye. Bye, guys. See ya.